Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dean Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.1, Problem 7. This is Section 5.1, Problem 7, and it asks, how much would Sue have to invest now at 9% compounded monthly to have $8,000 in 5 years? Now, if you've tried the previous problem, it's almost the same. The previous one says, how much does Sue have to invest now at 9% simple interest to have $8,000 in 5 years? So the difference is whether it's compounded or simple interest. So this one is compounded, so I'm going to go to the compound interest formula. Again, I know it's compounded because they talk about how it's monthly compounding. So the compound interest formula is A equals P times, in parentheses, 1 plus R over M, close the parentheses, to the M times T power. That's the compound interest formula. Now, A is the final amount, which in this case is $8,000. That's the final amount, not the principal. We want to figure out how much you put in. So in the last problem, it was about $5,500. So it should be somewhere in that range now. So that doesn't go in for P. That's what I expect when we solve for P that we'll find out it is. The $8,000 goes in for A, the final amount. E equals P, that's the unknown, so I'll leave it as a variable. And then in parentheses, 1 plus R over M is going to be 1 plus R, the rate as a decimal. The 9% is 0.09. The M, number of times compounded per year, because I have monthly compounding, M is 12. I close the parentheses. I have an exponent of M times T. Again, M is 12 for the monthly compounding. Times T is 5 because we want the money to grow for 5 years. T is the amount of time in years. So that's how the formula fills in. Now again, this formula has some parentheses. Any type of math, you have to do your work in parentheses first. So as I start, I'm going to have 8,000 equals P times. Now in parentheses, I have an addition and a division. I need to do the division first. So it's going to be 1 plus 0.09 divided by 12 is 0.0075. And again, if you don't see that easily, just use your calculator. I know 9 twelfths is 3 quarters or 0.75, but because of the decimal, instead of 0.75, it's 0.0075. But again, let's say you think that's what it is, but you're not sure, or for whatever reason, your calculator will figure it out. You want to put in the numerator of 0.09, divide by the denominator, 12 equals, and it'll tell you. So that's where the 0.0075 comes from. The exponent on the parentheses, 12 times 5, I might as well do now, that's 60. Now to finish my parentheses, in the parentheses I have to add 1 plus 0.0075, which I can do easily. So I have 8,000 equals P times, in parentheses, 1.0075, and I have an exponent of 60. So the next thing I need to figure out is that exponent. So I have to do 1.0075 to the 60th power. So that's 1.0075 times 1.0075 times 1.0075, et cetera, et cetera, 60 times. That needs to be done on a calculator. So with my calculator, I would put in 1.0075, and my exponent button is a button that looks like x with a superscript of y, x to the y power, and then I enter my exponent of 60 and press equals. On some calculators, the exponent button looks a little like an arrow that points up. They call it a caret. It would most likely be one of those two buttons, and again, I can't even begin to estimate that. So with my calculator, I'll put in the base of 1.0075, press the exponent button, put in the exponent of 60, hit equals, and I get an answer. So my formula now will say 8,000 equals P times 1.56561027. Now I'm gonna let all those decimals stay in my problem, and I'm just gonna round it at the end to two places for how many cents. Now, 8,000 equals P times 1.56, blah, 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 all those decimals. To get P by itself, I want to divide out the 1.56 whatever and isolate the P. So I'm going to have 8,000 over that big decimal thing, 15656810027. And again, that is not a division that I can figure out in my head. So with the calculator, you want to enter the 8,000 first, divide by that decimal of 15656810027. Now, that happens to be on the screen of my calculator now because I just did a computation where that was the answer. Now, I could just clear the whole thing, and when I do 8,000 divided by 1.56 whatever, enter it all again. But before you clear the calculator, if you're doing it with a calculator, just store it in memory. Then clear it and go 8,000 divided by recall memory, and you don't have to type it all in again. So it's not the end of the world if you type it all in again, but if you want to save some time, you can use the memory on your calculator, which is what I'll do. So 8,000 divided by recall memory gives me 51095975589. That's the final answer. That's how much we have to invest now, or Sue has to invest now at the 9% compounded monthly to have the $8,000. Now, since money is measured down to how many cents, I don't want to have six places after the decimal. It's totally unnecessary. I want to go to two places after the decimal. It's going to tell me how many pennies. So after the decimal, I have 0.597 and then some other stuff. Well, the 7 is big enough to make that 5.9 into a 60 cents. So my final answer will be $5,109.60. So if Sue invests $5,109.60 now at 9% compounded monthly, she's going to have the $8,000 in 5 years. Now, if you remember from the previous problem, if it was simple interest, not compounded, it was a little over $5,500. So because it's compounded, you need less money to reach your goal of $8,000. So the compounding helps.